really the monster here? Is it really him or is it really her?
Hey guys, this is Ariane Doing. I'm Anime Intensity and welcome back to my channel. Today we're actually having another Muggle First Take where I talk about cool new manga series. It's not like a full series review, it's more like a first impressions of these brand new series. Today's manga is actually being published by Kodansha Comics and it's also rated M for mature, so you know what? That's like, what, 17 and over? I don't even know at this point. 17, 18. Either way, it definitely has some mature themes, so if you know, you're uncomfortable with certain things or shouldn't be reading this kind of stuff, but you read it anyway. Trust me, I was like that too. Fair warning, this manga is rated M for mature content, and mainly because there is some things to be implicated and things that are a little inappropriate for younger audiences. Just putting that out there before I start talking about the manga, and then you open it and you're like, the first page, you're like, oh jeez, you know, that really actually... When I opened this, I was like, is this rated M? And then I looked in the back, I was like, oh, well, I guess that explains it. 18 plus, just putting that out there. I know you guys are going to read it either way, but just warn you. Anyway, today's manga is called Gleipnir. And I still don't know if I'm saying that correctly, but I think it's Gleipnir. This is by Sun Takeda or Sun Takeda? I assume it's Sun Takeda, but you know. But anyway, Gleipnir is a very odd manga, and you can probably tell that just by looking at the cover. You see this girl getting into this thing, fleshy, meaty, like, ooey, like, I don't even know how to describe it, this mascot kind of character. It's very, like, a matte finish, it's very smooth, not a glossy manga. And this manga is definitely filled with a lot of violence, and this boy just, you know, he transforms into this monster. He doesn't know why, and he's like, I just want to be normal. He just wants to fit in. He just wants to be, you know, friends with people at his school, be a normal kid, and he turns into this monster, this dog mascot. He ends up saving this girl right here, even though she didn't necessarily want to be saved, and now she's like, I'm so fascinated. You need to help me out. We need to help each other, and they're being chased and hunted down because they have a certain coin, and they're like, this other monster is like, hey, you better hand me that coin, and let's fight to the death for the coin. And so there's definitely some fighting and some violence going on, and we do learn that, as you see in this cover and as you see in the back, you and me together, she actually goes inside of this dude. This guy, you know, our main character, who I, Shuichi, because I never remember names, he can transform into this monster, but as you can see, it's kind of like a mascot-y character, something that you might see at an amusement park or something. And she's like, hey, I have an idea. You have a zipper on your back. Maybe I could go inside of you. She's like, you know what? Maybe if I just go and, you know, control you, you know, because you're a chicken and I have all the energy. So who is really the monster here? Is it really him or is it really her? Because she's just like really motivated to just attack people and use violence. Like, she's like all ready for it. And he's just like, please, I just want to be a pacifist. I just want to be, you know, me, myself, and I. And she's like, no, you got to use your power, you know? So, very interesting relationship between the two. That's all I'm going to say. It's probably going to get odder as volumes go by, but honestly, I thought this volume was very entertaining. You know, it's kind of an odd concept, and some of the moments are like, oh, jeez. But honestly, it went by really quickly. It was a fun read, despite being so weird. So, I actually do recommend it, because it was different, it was odd, but it was fun, it was entertaining, and it was actually really engaging, considering the fact that it's so weird. So, Gleipnir is... I just want to see more monsters. I want to see what else we see in Volume 2, and the danger, and what is up with that coin, because I have no idea. But then, that mysterious coin is definitely going to play a big role. We also see some other mysterious characters, which I will not... I don't want to say too much, and apparently she also has a sister. I want to know more about her sister, so definitely, if you read this manga, you'll know what I'm talking about. I don't want to spoil too much for you, but Gleipnir is a manga that's definitely a little bit out there, but it is entertaining. It is very entertaining, and it's engaging in its very own way. So,
I recommend it. It's about this kid who is just kind of scared of everything and just wants to be normal, but he's everything but normal. And then you have this girl who's like, hey, I am technically normal. I'm not a monster like you, but, you know, deep down inside, I think I have a monster inside me, you know? So she doesn't say that, but that's how I feel about our main character, Claire Aoki. Claire is a very interesting character, and I want to see where their relationship goes, but this manga is definitely a little bit out there. I hope you guys check it out regardless, so I'll get closer to show you what this volume looks like. I wish it could be a little sharper, but yeah. Mm-hmm. Look at that. Very interesting. Like I said, this is rated M, so I know you guys are going to read it regardless if you're interested in the story or not, so definitely check this manga out and let me know how you felt about it in the comment section, because I don't know how everyone will feel about this manga because it's just kind of odd. Thank you guys for watching, and like I said before, please like, share, or subscribe if you liked this video, and I will see you guys next time.